Guys, I love the Bombardiers. I always have. They got a buff, and I have a lot to talk about today with various trees. And in some ways, they surprised me, and in some ways, they disappointed. I had some high hopes with certain things, but where it disappointed me, it's not how you think. I have base fun builds for PvE that work really well. The best subclasses to use in the Crucible and more. They are fun, extremely fun to use. And it's one thing to look at all this in this video, but it's a completely other thing to try it out for yourself. I encourage you to try them out. Before I get into the video, I do want to give a huge shout out to a continuing sponsor of the channel, Surfshark VPN. It encrypts your data, keeps it safe, it's an extra layer of security for your photos, your videos, all your personal stuff, so no one can see it. It hides your true IP address, it's extremely easy to use, it sets you up with the closest server. And my favorite thing is that it's the only privacy product that allows unlimited simultaneous devices. Most of them limit you, but not Surfshark. You can have it on your phone, your desktop, as many devices as you want. It works as an app or a browser extension, and that allows you to place your phone or laptop anywhere in the world. Let's take HBO Max. It isn't available in some countries, so you just change your location and it's gonna open up. For Netflix, there are about 15 different Netflix libraries out there to go out and explore. With changing your location to different areas, you can see what's playing around the world. And when it comes to gaming, you can game in full privacy and security. That includes big ones like hiding your IP in Discord, other chats, not have to worry about it. Protection is key. Use my code COOLGUY to get 83% off plus 3 extra months free. There's a link down below right at the top of the description. And if for whatever reason you're unhappy, they do back a 30-day money-back guarantee, so there's no risk to try it out yourself. I really hope you get behind Surfshark as they've gotten behind me. It's a really good deal that they have for us. I did a Bombardier pre-buff video, and here's a quick refresher. The exotic perk is Parting Gift. Dodging leaves behind an explosive that detonates after a short delay, damaging enemies around it. The bomb is free damage out of thin air, and it's tied to your dodge. With its buff, there's an ability effect depending on your subclass of choice. With 100 mobility, your dodge is every 11 seconds. It can be sped up with things like Bottom Tree Arcstrider. Sprinting recharges your dodge ability, and there's a couple more. High mobility is key. 8, 9, or 10, you want to get that dodge to drop that bomb. The base bomb comes out from where you dodged from, right in the center. You can move around it for a split second, then it detonates. The bomb reaches out spherically 7.5 meters. The timers and the abilities change a bit between PvE and PvP. The damage for base depends on how close your enemy is to the bomb. In the Crucible, if they're right on top of it, the max damage is 120. As they're further away, let's say 5 to 7 meters, it decays 105, 180, the outer limit's around 70 damage. In PvE, the bomb damage is about the same, nearly the same, as a high-impact sniper body shot. It is an ad destroyer. It does decent there, not great, but it clears ads well and does decent damage to majors and above. But now, they got this buff. The buff goes like this. The bomb now has a secondary effect based on your subclass type. Blind for arc, burn for solar, slow for stasis, suppress for void. And note, the suppression does not affect a guardian and super. It does work a little bit differently in PvE and PvP, so let's go ahead and look into that. For arc blinding in PvE, it does put them in that stun blind position. The area of effect is within the bomb radius, that's 7.5 meters. It's not like a blinding GL where you just kind of nuke the whole area and everything's gonna be blinded. It won't work on champions, but it will work on some majors named yellow bars. And for PvE, the blind, it lasts for 7 seconds. You can use that time to tee off with a fusion, 1-2 punch, and more. In the Crucible, the blinding lasts for 3 seconds. The arc blinding bomb is the only one that differs with distance. So if you're right next to it, it's gonna be like a flashbang. Screen goes white, the HUD goes down, it lasts for 3 seconds in the Crucible. If you're far away from the bomb, that 5 to 7 meters, the bomb of course does less damage, but the blinding effect does last for 3 seconds, but it's not heavy. Mostly just your HUD's gonna be down, nowhere near as if you were right next to it. For solar, the solar burn does 5 ticks. No matter how far away the enemy is, doesn't matter if it's in PvE or PvP, if something gets hit, it's gonna do the bomb damage and it's gonna burn 5 times. In the Crucible, it does 5 ticks of 6 damage, so you combine that with the 120 from the bomb, it's a 150 damage hit, pretty good. For void suppression, in PvE that means captains won't teleport, knights won't throw up a shield, and it completely just stuns wizards. In PvE, the suppression effect lasts for 9 seconds. That's a good amount of time to stop those abilities. In the Crucible, it works similar to the suppression grenade, minus not being able to knock out a super. When you are suppressed, you can't double jump, used a charged melee, use your super, nothing. The suppression effect lasts for 7 seconds. So even though you can't take them out of a super, you can delay them from doing so, and you can stop things like a shatter dive animation and so on. Stasis, kinda odd, the bomb adds slow. Basically, this is a PvE only thing for Bombardiers, because if you were just to apply your slow dodge and then a shuriken, no freeze. But if you were to have a stack from the slow dodge, a stack from the bomb, and then the shuriken, it does freeze a target. It's like the old school PvP dodge and throw. It can work there in PvE. In the Crucible though, it doesn't matter. It has a slight 1 second slow effect, and it doesn't stack like it does in PvE. It's the same result no matter what. Slow dodge, bomb, then slowing, then a shuriken, nothing. You would need two of those thrown melees, and no matter what, that means a down. It's enough damage. So stasis, not so good with the Bombardier's buff. The big thing to take away, all effects are applied within the bomb radius, 7.5 meters, all of them. The only effect that differs with distance is blinding arc. The blind severity depends on how close your enemy is to the bomb, but the suppression burns slow. They all do their effect no matter what if they get tagged right on top of it or 7 meters out. So for each one of these, I want to talk about usage. I first want to take a look at Solar, causing burn with the bomb. There's a lot to go through today, but as the season goes on, I might put some things together for a more in-depth video. On Middle Tree Blade Barrage, this is the best. The perks in the tree for Blade Barrage are Burning Edge. While enemies burn, your dodge ability recharges faster. Knife Trick, throw a fan of knives that burns targets on hit. Playing with Fire, destroying the burning enemies, recharges Knife Trick more quickly. And in the pre-buff video, I called that there's a possibility of an endless loop, and there is. The bomb adds burning, that's now giving you dodge. When you down those burning targets, that's getting you your knife. You have things like Gambler's Dodge, that's gonna give you that melee back as you dodge near your enemy. Endless loop! You also have the incendiary grenade to apply burn. In PvE, you can have on things like Explosive Wellmaker. The bomb procs those solar elemental wells. I also have on Melee Wellmaker. Getting kills with a charged melee drops a well, so I'm gonna be throwing out constant bombs. And with those bombs and knife trick, constant knives. And since it is that loop, you can get those melee final blows with those knives, it's gonna drop a well. And then you add on this season's artifact, Thermoclastic Blooming, powered melee final blows spawn an orb of light. Endless combinations, I also have on Reeling Wellmaker. That's for Void. After activating your class ability, your next weapon final blow spawns a Void Elemental Well. Then Font of Might. There's a lot of abilities going on with Middle Tree Blade Barrage with the Bombardiers. And I don't have the new Bountiful Well mod. That would be great with these. It is constant abilities, constant wells with Middle Tree. It's pretty fun. Then you have things like with the Artifact mod where your Solar Melee can stun champions. And you just bully overloads with Blade Barrage. It's a fun general play setup. Again, endless bombs. For the Crucible, extremely fun. Same thing, since that bomb now burns, if you tag an enemy with it and they survive and run away, it's gonna be enough to get your dodge back. You still have the grenade and the knives to burn your target as well. The Bombardiers as a whole are best used defensively. Someone's rushing you, it happens every game. You're gonna make them eat that bomb. Now they're gonna have the ability tied to it, and in this case, burn. You can also use it offensively as well. And one thing I'm probably gonna say a couple times, there's a couple of exceptions and Solar is an exception. At the start, I said I was somewhat disappointed, but that's only because the distance that it shares with the bomb, these abilities, that 7.5 meters and in. With the bomb doing 120, your melee follow-up, your shotgun, your sidearm, gets that final blow. A lot of the time, the ability itself doesn't really matter. It's gonna have the same outcome as it did before pre-buff. But this isn't to say that the applied ability won't help, or can't help because it can. Solar is different. With Blade Barrage, you're constantly getting your dodge back. And also, you can actually burn out enemies because of that bomb. And the burning stops recovery, it can stop a revive, it can stop power weapon pickups. The Solar Bombardier Bomb is very noticeable in the Crucible. Well, in PvE too because of all of its burning. Try it on Middle Tree, see how it combos, it's really fun. But that isn't to say Top Tree can't work well either. Because you can combo the bomb with that throwing knife. They get close, or they're rushing around a corner, you dodge, drop that bomb, jump up in the air, throw the knife down right on top of them. And you can also combo any Solar Gunslinger Tree with the Swarm Grenade as well. Say you know someone's rushing you, you can just throw the Swarm at your feet. As they're coming around the corner, they're gonna come right into the Swarm Grenade, eat the bomb, and it's gonna be a final blow. Or you can just dodge and then throw the Swarm at the feet. The bomb burn is really good. Next arc, Blinding. Top Tree Arc Strider, Deadly Reach, Combat Flow, Combination Blow. Getting melee kills resets your dodge. Kill an enemy with the melee to get health regeneration. And get an increase to melee damage temporarily, stacks of times 3. Now this goes for PvE and PvP, it's gonna be Top Tree Strider. In PvP, the blinding effect is based on how close they are to the bomb. With Deadly Reach, you're gonna be able to jump right up in the air after dodging, and that Deadly Reach lunge, 99 out of 100 times, you're gonna be close enough just to get the melee follow-up. So the effect to me really doesn't matter too much. There are times like this right here, this player got hit with the big blind. I know they did, so yeah, for 3 seconds, That player was less than half health because they got hit with the full bomb. They were going to be an easy cleanup because they couldn't see. They were just kind of searching and looking around. So yeah, I do think that Assassin's Cal is going to be a better pick with Top Tree. I've covered that before, but that isn't to say that the Bombardiers can't do well. But they do well because of the 120 bomb damage. You hit them, you follow up with the melee with Deadly Reach. They added the blinding, but you're never really going to know if that was the reason you got the down. I do like them, they work, but it was doing this before the buff. You could do this well before the buff. You can also use things like Middle Tree with the Tempest Strike. You could throw the bomb, you could follow up with the strike after. It does okay. I do think the Top Tree Strider has the best synergy just because you get to reset your dodge and just keep going. In PvE, the bomb trashes adds. We've talked about this. So you're only going to be really using it to blind majors. Again, then tee off on them as they're stunned. You use the same type of build as Solar, but add in Overcharge Wellmaker. Defeating a combatant with a finisher spawns two Arc Elemental Wells, and then Well of Ions. Picking up that Arc Well causes your next melee to deal increased damage. And then Font of Might for your weapon. So you can have on an Arc 1-2 Punch Shotgun. Do your finishers, get your wells. The shotgun's doing more damage because of Font of Might. The next melee, so you're in Combination Blow times 3. You proc Well of Ion with that, it's good damage. It's decent, it works. The next are kind of iffy to me, Void. Here's the deal. In the Crucible, there are two things I like about it, but we need to be a realist about it. It suppresses them for 7 seconds, so one good thing is the suppression, stopping a Shatter Dive, nade throws, super activation. Now the second thing, on Top Tree, you dodge, you suppress them, you go invisible. With that suppression screen, it's hazy, so you're kind of tough to see while you're invisible. That's a good thing. It's very easy for your opponent to lose sight of you. But same thing, I don't really think that the suppression matters too much. There's a big difference at what this does to your build compared to Blade Barrage. And just like with Top Tree Strider and Arc, it would have the same outcome no matter what, pre-buff or not. And for Night Stalker, the Graviton Forfeit buff takes the Night Stalker trees to a new level. You can use it on any tree. Insane recovery, insane reload, your melee recharges faster. The Forfeit's way too good to pass up versus this. You can make Bombardiers work, sure, but at what cost? In PvE, same thing. The suppression on majors, it's iffy because you have Graviton Forfeit there. You have Omni Oculus. Those exist, Orpheus Rigs. And you can't really do with the Night Stalker trees what you can do with, let's say, the Blade Barrage tree or even Top Tree Strider. Those melees resetting your dodge there. The flow isn't really there with Night Stalker for the Bombardiers. Then we have Slow with Stasis. I don't think it's worth it at all for the Crucible. PvE, it does add a stack enough to do the dodge, shuriken, freeze combo. It's going to be up to you if that's going to be worth it or not. To use it over Bacchus and other things, me personally, no. For PvE or PvP, top uses for these buffed Bombardiers go to Top Tree Arc Strider and Blade Barrage. It does work on all trees, but the combination of what's in that skill tree with what you can do with Bombardiers is what makes it special. It does send them to another level. It does elevate them. Blade Barrage turns into a monster, and honestly, that's been a very bad tree for a long time, and this makes it tolerable. But the side note, you're left with the Blade Barrage super, so one step forward, two steps back kind of deal. You can make some great builds. There's a lot to explore with PvE with build crafting. And in the Crucible, certain trees are tiers above others. And as far as that disappointment, I've said it a couple times. It's more so that 90% of the time in the Crucible, it would have had the same outcome pre-buff. You never really know if that ability applied was the reason you came out on top. The only active thing that you can see is the Blade Barrage Solar Burn and them burning out and stopping reses, things like that. And sure, if you hit them with the bomb, with let's say Night Stalker, you suppress them and you go down, yeah, for 5-6 seconds as your teammate is closing in or they're running around, they can't do anything. There's those little points that need to be brought up. But overall, they are good. You have to build heavy into them in PvE, and in the Crucible, they're still one of the best get out of my personal space exotics in the game. And I want to point out, they could have made these really strong, but they confined it within that 7.5 meter bomb detonation. And honestly, that serves it the best, and they did a pretty good job with them. If you're new here, remember to hit the subscribe button, and if you are subscribed, thank you so much for your support. Go check out Surfshark. Let's talk about Bombardiers down below. What are you liking about them? What do you think? Thank you for watching, and until the next one, I am Cool Guy.